Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple wheelbarrow in SOLIDWORKS. I hope you like it. So let's see how to design each and every part and assemble at the end. This is a very simple and easy project and it is widely used component in the world. I hope you like it. Now here we will make our first part of wheelbarrow bucket. Steel bucket, so let's start. Choose your right plane, sketch. Let's create one geometry, horizontal, and connect. This is the simple geometry of bucket. Let's define it. Choose smart dimension, 86 millimeter, 58 millimeter. Let's make the angle 55 millimeter, 160 millimeter, 55 millimeter, 55 millimeter. Okay, now select this line and make relation horizontal. Okay, now see the drawing is fully defined, so simply exit. Now we need to create one plane. So let's choose right plane and select this line. We want to create a perpendicular line to this one, so select OK. Now we will create a one geometry here, so select this plane, a sketch. Now here we will make one simple geometry, so select normal, select here line. Exit. Now it's time to make some relation. Select isometric view, then you will see the select this sharp edge, a point, and select this line midpoint. The here also the same, this point and this line coincident. Normal, select this line, make relation vertical, and here also vertical. It's time to define this one. Millimeter. Let's make the angle 5 degrees. Now see, simply we define this one, exit. Now just hide this plane. Now it's time to choose top plane, a sketch, normal, select here line, exit. Now this is also the same situation. Select this line, word, just undo, and select this corner point, midpoint. Here also, this corner point and this line, and make relation midpoint. Choose normal, that's fine. Both the horizontal, so it's no need to define, just define the dimension. 85 millimeter. 70 millimeter. Exit. Now see, we created our geometry. Now let's go to feature, select here lofted boss base, clear, and select this point and similarly this point. Now see, you can see the preview of body. No need to create any other relation, it's simple. Okay, that's it. Let's hide this geometry. Choose fillet 12 millimeter and select these four corners. Okay, now again choose fillet, keep 10 millimeter and select this one. Okay, that's it. Now choose here shell, keep thickness 1 millimeter and select this face. You can select here show preview and you can see the preview. Okay, just click perspective so that looks better. Choose here right plane. Where is right plane? Sketch. And here we will select here hidden line visible. Now here we will make one we want to avoid the sharp edges, so we will create a curve. Select the line. Okay, draw a curve. Again draw a half circle. Just go back to this point and it will automatically convert. Then again come back this point and it will automatically convert and connect. Exit. Select this circle and this circle. Select both the circles. Make concentric. That's fine. Keep radius 1 millimeter. And this one I think by default 0.5 millimeter. And let's choose this point. Fully add define sketch, calculate. Okay, now that your sketch is fully defined, it is not any important thing. Now simply exit and choose here sweep to boss base. And here see profile selected, just select the path. So select this line. Do one thing, clear, right click, selection manager, and select here close loop. Select select this one, select group, this one, this one, this one. Select one by one all the lines. Close group. Okay, let's select one by one, then we will see. Select OK. Now you can see the preview. Select OK. Now this is the our feature boss base. Now see the sharp edge. We just avoid the sharp edge for safety purpose. Now here we want to make a hole, but we will do the hole during assembly. So let's select red color or go to appearance plastic. We want to make some plastic cover, or sometime we made this one with plastic, but that's too dark actually. And if you will choose this one, okay, this is the high gloss plastic. Let's save this one. Go to desktop and create one folder. Wheel barrow. and let's make the first part bucket. That's it. Save. Now let's see the other parts. Hole here we will make letter. During assembly we will locate the dimension, then we will make the hole. It's better option, better. Now here let's make the next part, bucket frame or wheelbarrow frame. So let's start here. We will choose your right plane, sketch, center line. Draw a horizontal and vertical center line. Let's make bottom. Okay, now let's choose a line. Draw a line, exit, again choose line, let's exit, let's define this line first, draw vertical line to this, exit, select both the line, make relation perpendicular, okay. It's time to define it. 10 millimeter. This length keep 45 millimeter. Six millimeter and select this one, 25 millimeter, draw here a horizontal line, this line no need actually, delete this one, note down the dimension very carefully, 10 degree. Now this line is fully defined. Now choose a line here, convert it into arc. Now convert it, go back to this point and it will automatically convert into arc. Extend this one. Make sure tangent. Select this two line tangent. It is met here. Now again choose the line. Go back and convert in arc. And draw in upward direction. Exit. Now here choose spline. And we want to connect this from here to select this one. Now let's define this point first. This point and this point, make vertical distance 17 millimeter. Okay. Keep angle only 5 degree. Select this center from this line, 115 millimeter. 52 millimeter. Okay, then let's draw one line here, center line. Actually we want to draw a vertical center line. Make sure it is vertical. Let's make the angle 5 degrees. Keep the radius 15 millimeter. See, 12 millimeter, 12 millimeter. Now let's define this angle. Make sure here one line exit. Okay, this one 5 degrees, that's fine. Millimeter. Let's define this length 80 millimeter. Now I think we defined all the dimensions. Select circle and draw one circle here. Select for construction purpose 50 millimeter. Here we forget to add one relation, tangent. Tangent. Actually here no need for this circle, but just only for here define the angle 10 degrees. Okay, now here also you need one relation, tangent relation. Now see, this drawing is fully defined now. Okay. This circle I think no need. This one also defined 6 millimeter. 10 millimeter. Let's click here fully defined sketch, calculate, undo, cancel it. I think something we forget here, but that's the our full drawing and it's sufficient for us. Let's check one more time angle. Ten degrees, that's exit. Now this time choose top plane, sketch, normal. Select here line and start from this point. Go back and convert into arc. It's not going to convert, then do one thing, directly choose 3-point arc. Exit, choose your line, go to straight, keep radius 15 millimeter. Okay. Now select this point and this point, horizontal, normal. Then choose line. Then comes here. Draw a taper then convert into arc, little taper, not much, then draw exit. Do one thing, select this end point and this point. End point and this point horizontal, this point horizontal. Let's choose this 2 points horizontal relation. Very carefully select these 2 points ISO. Now the only here we need to draw spline. Here select tangent. The same thing we have to do it here. Tangent relation. That's fine. Now we will define some dimensions here. R15 we already selected. Angle, degree, select this point and this point, 65 millimeter. Then we have to choose here this point and this point, 30 millimeter. That's it. This one we already had. Make it 15 millimeter. Okay. Select these 2 lines and circle tangent relation. Now that's enough. Fully defined sketch, calculate. Okay. I hope you note down all the dimension. This is very critical dimension. You must note down properly and properly do it. Otherwise, your geometry will be mesh. And you will be mesh. Exit. Go to feature. select here project curve. Select one sketch, select second sketch, and you can see the preview. Okay, this is what we got. Choose right plane, sketch, select circle, and draw one circle here. Draw two circles. Okay, 6 millimeter, and let's make the gap 1 millimeter. Okay, now select the center point and this line pierce. You can see here exit. Choose sweep to boss base. Now here first select the profile. Now then choose the path. You can see the profile and path relation. Select OK. Now here we selected the pipe. That's it. Select top plane. Sketch normal. Now here we want to create some holes. Select both the circles and make relation equal. 13 millimeter the gap. 2 millimeter, and let's define the gap. Select extruded cut, reverse direction. Or leave it, hole we will make during assembly. Exit. Delete these holes. Select right plane, mirror, select the full geometry. Okay. Now our frame is ready. See, just hide this curve. Now let's define material, raw material. Just go to appearance, metal, steel. It's look better because it's dark, so that's fine. Save. Part number 2, frame. Now here let's make the third part, grip, handle grip. So let's start. Choose here front plane, sketch, draw two circles, keep outer one 7.5 millimeter, and let's make the gap between these two 0.75 millimeter, and extrude up to 24 millimeter. Okay, now select the back surface, sketch, select outer one, convert entity, extrude, only 1 millimeter reverse direction. Okay, now it's closed from one end. Now choose right plane, sketch, normal. First draw a center line. Select here line. Now let's make dimension 5 by 5 millimeter. Exit. Now select the center point and this line coincide. Linear pattern. Clear. Select these four lines and come up, make the gap 5.2 millimeter, reverse direction, four numbers. Okay, fully defined. Calculate. Okay, you can manually define this all dimensions, it's not big deal. Then select here, exit, choose split line and select this surface. We want to split this line into this surface. Select here projection. Okay, now see, now just go to insert feature and choose here dome option. Select this four faces and keep the dome 1 millimeter. This is the actually hand grip. Okay, fill it. Let's try 1 millimeter. Okay, now we will apply the material rubber. So go to appearance and you'll find here rubber, matte rubber. That's fine. See, this is the grip. Save part number 3 grip. Save. Let's check out other parts. Now here let's make the steel pin, front plane, a sketch, and draw a circle with 3.58 millimeter. Let's keep the diameter 3.8 millimeter. Go to feature, select extruded boss and extrude up to 35 millimeter. Now you can see the preview. Okay, let's make some chamfer. 0.5 also, it's too big. 0.2 millimeter. Okay, that's fine. Now define some material. Go to steel, this is better, satin finish stainless steel. Let's save. And this one actually a spindle. Save. This is actually pin, wheel pin actually. Now here the next part is wheel spacer. So let's start. Choose here front. Let's choose top plane, sketch, and draw two circles here. Outer one keep 8 millimeter, and let's make the gap between these two circles go inside. Let's make the gap 2 millimeter and select extruded boss base and extrude up to 4.75 millimeter. Okay. Try chamfer 1 millimeter. Select this body 1 millimeter. Also too big. Okay. This is the wheel spacer. Let's define some material. Go to metal, brass. Let's define some dark satin finish copper. Does look perfect. Save. 5. Wheel spacer. Here the next part is bearing block. So let's start. Keep right plane, sketch. Select here circle and let's draw 2 circles. Choose here line. And again connect with this. Now let's define. 8 millimeter, inner one 4 millimeter, 4 millimeter, overall 18 millimeter. Okay, now do one thing, select both the end points and origin points and make I think there is no relation, so center line. Now try select center line and both the outer line, make relation symmetric. That's fine. Choose trim entity, power trim, drag, press drag and cut it. Okay, go to feature, select extruded boss base, keep end condition mid plane and keep the thickness 5 millimeter. Okay, select this wall or face. Now here we want to make circular face. First draw a line, construction line, circle. Let's draw the circle 6 millimeter. Keep the length also 6 millimeter. Select here extruded cut. End condition through all. Okay, now that's it. Select the back surface, sketch, select one end to another end, circle, draw here and here 2 circles. Select both the circle, make relation equal. Gap 13 millimeter, diameter 2 millimeter. Okay, and distance from origin point just half, 6.5 millimeter. That's it. Select here extruded cut and we want to cut here a hole actually, so keep end condition through all. Okay, that's it. Fill it 1 millimeter. Okay, that's it. Let's make it some dark color for this. Okay, save, bearing block. Now let's check out the rim and wheel. Now let's do the next part, rim. So here choose top plane, sketch, center line, horizontal and vertical center line. Let's start from here. Then convert it into arc. Then again come back to this point and it will automatically convert it in, and exit. Now let's define this one. Millimeter. Seven millimeter. Choose your fillet, add this one and make the radius 1.5 millimeter. The same we will do it here. Okay. Fill it. Dimension keep 2 millimeter. Now it's time to define some angle. Eleven degree. Just keep with this. Make sure it is tangent relation, because this is very important relation, tangent relation. Now let's make this 4 millimeter. Five point zero five millimeter. Here radius 1 millimeter. One point five millimeter and 0.775 millimeter. Now let's check this 8.775 millimeter. And distance from here to bottom, this one is the important, 14.578 millimeter. Now see, the design drawing is fully defined. So select here revolve boss base, select yes, select this line as a axis of rotation. Choose your thin feature. Keep the thickness. Point 5 millimeter. Uncheck. Let's check out again. Cancel, normal, and delete this one, and we will try. Select no, axis of rotation this one, and now see, thickness is selected 0.75 millimeter. This is what we want. Select OK. Now see the thickness. Now choose here right plane, mirror, select the body to mirror, select the full body. Okay, now see this is the rim. Now we will define this one some, let's define some metal color, that's better. Or even you can define chrome, but chrome is too light, so I always preferred satin finish. That looks awesome. Rib. Now let's make the tire. Here let's make the last part of wheelbarrow tire. So let's start. Choose here top plane, sketch, center line, vertical and horizontal center line. Make sure both vertical and horizontal. Let's choose here center point arc. Let's exit. Select both the end points horizontal. Go back to this point and it will automatically convert into an arc, then bottom, exit. Now it's time to define this one. Keep radius 9 mm, 21 mm, and the distance from here to bottom 19 mm. Fillet 1 mm, 0.5 mm. Okay, choose mirror and select these three lines and mirror against this vertical line. Okay, that's fine. Now choose dimension and select the center distance, keep 14 mm. Okay, now you can see the geometry is fully defined. So let's select revolve boss base and select no this axis of revolution, and thickness 0.75 mm, that's enough for us. Okay, now again choose stop plane, a sketch normal, let's choose a circle. Draw a circle. Keep offset 0.5 mm. Okay, now select the outer circle and this circle, make relation symmetric. Okay, now go to right click surface, choose your surfaces, go to surface. Let's draw a horizontal line, center line. Surface, select extruded surface. Cancel it, revolve a surface. Now see, it's going to revolve a circular way. Okay. See, this is the circular way. Later we will delete it or even we will hide it. Choose one, we want to create one plane first, front plane, plane, make it flip, 35 millimeter. Okay, select sketch normal. Now here we will draw our tire treads. So select here line, and I'll choose any random dimension. Is not necessary to select extruded cut. Reverse direction and up to surface, select this surface. Okay, now hide this plane and select this surface, hide. Now it's time to make multiple number of cutouts. Circular pattern, select here, select this circular face, and here select these cutouts, and here make 40 number of patterns. Okay, now it will take time for calculation, but that's it. So this is our wheel. Let's do one thing, go to rubber, glossy rubber, not matte rubber, that's perfect. But this one is enough. Save tire. Now let's start the assembly of wheelbarrow. Let's start the assembly of wheelbarrow. Select here file, new assembly. Let's browse our first part. We will keep our first part, large icon, frame. Okay, let's change the color. Grip, open. Press Ctrl key and copy. Mat, select inside and outside of grip. Select the inside face of grip and this face. Coincident relation. The same thing we have to do it here. Select inside face and this side face. Coincident relation. Select the frame and inside hole of grip. Concentric relation. Now the grip is fixed here. Let's move our next part. We will choose here this time two parts. Press Ctrl key, rim and tire, open. So let's bring here mat, this one and this one. Concentric relation, that's fine. right plane of rim and go to tire, and here also we need to choose one plane. Press control key, right plane of tire and rim, right plane, choose met, select coincident relation. Okay, that's perfectly fixed here. Okay, let's browse the other part. This time we will browse 1, 2. Okay, now press control key and copy, choose here mat, select this face, concentric relation, select this face, coincident relation. The same thing we need to do it here, drag to opposite direction, select this face and this face, and here select flip alignment. Okay, that's it. Now we fixed one thing, now let's fix the other thing. Select inside hole and this pin or spindle, concentric relation, let's choose advanced mat width, select both the outer edge of spindle, then this outer face of spacer. Now it comes in mid position, select OK. Now that's it. Now wheel also we want to fix with this. So let's try tire right plane and select frame, press control key, right plane of frame, met. Okay, make little down. Now we will fix this one with the help of a important part, browse bearing block, press control key and copy one more block, open this part and let's reduce, make the color little dark because this. Okay, cancel, save. Now it's become dark, that's fine. Choose here mat, select this pin and this hole, make relation concentric, select this two faces, coincident. Now select this face and this face, and we need to make okay, concentric relation, that's fine. The same thing we need to do opposite direction. Let's check this one. Okay, select pin, spindle and hole of bearing block, concentric relation, select this face and this face, coincident relation. Now select the inside face of bearing and pipe, make relation concentric, that's fine. Now here the wheel is fixed. Actually we need to terminate one tire mat terminate this relation, delete. Now let's try. Now it's rotating. That's perfectly rotating. Now we need to fix somewhere, keep little gap. Now here we want to make a hole and we will fix with this. So there is one important thing, click on this edit feature. Okay, it will ask you save and continue. Save wheelbarrow assembly. Okay, now cancel this one. Select this face sketch and select this circle. Press Ctrl key, this circle. Be carefully check convert entities and select. We want to extrude feature. Where exactly those all features? Select here, select this one, extrude, cut. Now see, it's hole going to cut from here, little increase. Okay, now that's extrude cut, edit feature, cancel, edit sketch, and do the same thing for opposite direction. Select this hole and this hole, convert entities. Exit. Now that's it. The hole is created. This is the fix. Here we will fix the bolt and our wheel will be fixed here. Now here choose mat. Select this hole and this hole. Concentric relation. The same thing, just do in opposite direction. Hole and pipe hole. Clear. It's not going to happen. Let's try this. I don't know why this not. Concentric relation, that's fine. Okay, that's it. Now see, the wheel is fixed here, it will rotate here. Now let's bring our last part. I think we fixed all the parts here. Now let's make the last part, bucket. Choose frame, right, bucket, control key right plane, mat. Okay. Select this face and this, make relation tangent. Select this face and this, make relation tangent. It should be tangent from outside. Now the bucket is fixed. See, it will not move. Okay, here even we can create the hole also, but that's fine. We don't, no need to do any hole or anything. We will do one thing, rim, and we will change the color of rim, make it red, and we will define some low gloss. No, that's not also good. Okay, that's fine. Yes, that's it. So this is our wheelbarrow. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video. If you have any comment, just write down below. I'll try to answer each and every question. Even if you want to give some animation, you can give it some animation also, but that's enough. It's simple. Let's save it. Save all. Save all. And please like our share our video. Thanks for watching.